Good morning. This is Diary of a Coach, episode 24. And the title of my conversation today says, Plan to Reinvent Yourself. Plan to Reinvent Yourself. Some of us say, oh, I've been a practicing coach for 25 years. I've been a multi-level marketer for 50 years. I've been a medical doctor for 20 years. I've been a nurse for 35 years. I've been a teacher for 13 years. I've been a proprietor or a school owner or an educationist for 40 years. And when I hear these things, it reminds me of those days when somebody would say, I've given my life to Christ since 60 years ago. I was the founding member of this church 40 years ago. My brother, good to see you, man. Nigerians seem to take pride in longevity of work rather than impact. We take pride in how long we have been in that practice rather than how well we have navigated the practice. Don't be caught in that rut, my brother and my sister. Don't be caught in that rut. I was talking with a friend last week, and we were discussing the mental health bill. And she was talking about the composition of the committee that drafted the bill. And she said majority, if not all, are made up of medical doctors, of repute, sages, like principalities, people we don't tell. And when you attempt to correct any part of the draft, they'll say, do you know were you born when I was a surgeon? Were you born when I was a consultant doctor? Where were you? Maybe your father and your mother had not even met. In other words, if you are young, you cannot add value. If you are young, you cannot contribute to the conversation where there are old people. These things don't make sense. As a life coach, or as a business coach, or as a relationship coach, or as a parenting coach, or as a coach of anything, you must consistently reinvent yourself. You must understand that a few things cannot, in fact, not a few, many things cannot be constant. How the practice of coaching was 5 years ago is not how it is now. It will not be like that in 5 years' time. It will not. So you need to understand that times are changing and times are evolving, and you must reinvent yourself. See, there are times when your work will plateau. And plateau means that niche that you say you are pushing and you are branding. It comes to a point where it is either saturated, many people are doing it, or people are not coming to you because you are sounding like an old drum. You must sit back and appraise your results and say, am I still getting the kind of results that I want? Because if you don't appraise your results, you will think that you are succeeding. Meanwhile, you are actually retrogressing. And you cannot afford it. So you must learn to reinvent yourself. The niche you are pushing, is it still relevant? See, there were careers that didn't exist 10 years ago. They now exist. Careers like hypers, people that hype, social media specialists, content developers, SEO experts. All those things didn't exist 10 years ago. Today they exist. They will not exist. They may not exist 10 years coming. Or new influx of careers may come in. Not may itself, it will. In the next 10 years. So if you are stuck onto your niche and you are feeling like a King Kong, well, I welcome you to a place of frustration. You must practice reinventing yourself. Practice reinventing yourself. And so that for the purpose of this module, and this episode, let me quickly itemize 3 things you must do to reinvent yourself. Number one, don't be allergic to training. You know, 2 days ago, episode 22, I talked about don't streamline your training and personal development, you know, and I said don't be jumping from training to training. Today, the opposite. Some people don't even want to go for training. Don't be allergic to training. Some of you are internet students and internet graduates. The only thing you know are the things you learned on the internet. Internet graduates carrying portfolio up and down, calling themselves coaches. It does not work like that, though. You cannot reinvent yourself if you refuse to attend a formal structured training. Be open to training. At least one minimum, worst case scenario, one big training every 2 years. And multiple trainings within the year, at least once a quarter or once every half year. Very important. Don't be allergic to training. Number two, always benchmark globally. The niche you think you're operating in Nigeria is not adequate. I have said this many times. You are a Nigerian. You are practicing in Nigeria, but you're not a Nigerian coach. You must open your mind to international standards. One way to reinvent yourself is to benchmark against global practice. What is happening in other continents and other spheres? Find out. Then number three, you must understand the next generation. One significant way to reinvent yourself is to understand the next generation. They call them millennials right now. They say they are delinquent, they say they are rebellious, they say they are unwilling, they say they are uncooperative. Guess what? If you understand their thinking, you may not fully understand it, but if you understand their methods and their approach, you will find that, man, if I reinvent myself, is a plus. Understand the next generation to become a motivation for reinventing yourself. Very, very important. I will leave these 3 points at this level. This is episode 24 of Diary of a Coach, titled Plan to Reinvent Yourself. Tomorrow, on episode 25, I'll be giving free airtime to 10 people who will be live on my video. So set your notification to be told when I'm live. I want to thank you guys for joining me today. Idenyi, always here. God bless you, sir. Okudero Adeni, thank you so much. Caroline Chikodi, good to see you. Haruna Chiroma, bro, good to see you. Solomon Okeke, good morning, my love. Good to see you. Chizota Mary, I am fit. I'm fit like a fiddle. I'm fine. Thank you so much for asking. God bless you. Haruna, Dr. Malik, good to see you, bro. Adams Aliyu Baba, good to see you. Temi Abiodun, good to see you. Good to see you. Mercedes, Mercurial Mercedes, thanks for waiting on me. I appreciate you. God bless you. Agnes Singbo, good to see you, my love. How have you been? Ngozi, good to see you, Ukamaka. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Yes, then he says, you have troubled the crocodile waters by this episode today. For me, I usually say, keep educating yourself. Thank you so much, my brother, for the tags and everything you have done for me. Chizota says, that stuck to niche, I was on that table. Yesterday, I was going through my resources on my PC and I saw all the training I have not utilized and packaged. I say, ha. I'm on this table. So good to see you. Good to read from you. If you're in Abuja and you can plan to come to Abuja, 1st of May, I'm holding a class from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. talking about how to create a coaching course. So Mary, for instance, Chizota, you have content you have not created courses for. Come to that class and you would know how to utilize it. Ayo, Yetunde, good to see you, darling. Chiroma, computer science is in another cooler. Don't worry, it's in another box. Thanks for asking, bro. Good to see you. I celebrate you. Now you're a PhD, bro. Congratulations. Well done. So thank you for watching my video. Please do me one favor, just one. Please share. That's all. Thank you and God bless you.